Look at my pumpkins. This is another win of the week. These are pumpkin seeds that I harvested from my actual pumpkins that I grew. Before we start the video, I just want to give a shout out to all of my super chatters from last night. Thank you so, so much. 100% of super chats go to boxes for our boys in the military. My son is a sergeant in the army and he is stationed somewhere in Eastern Europe, which I won't say due to national security. So without further ado, Tammy Hughes, thank you for the super chat. Lucinda Grant, thank you. Madeline Hall, thank you. Michelle Moon, thank you. Mama G, thank you. And Prepping with Sarge, thank you so, so much. The boys in my son's platoon always request drink mixes. And my goodness, not only do I have enough to send a whole box with shipping, I have enough to fill the box and send it. So I'm very excited. I'll be going to Dollar General and using my $5 off $25 coupon for that. Hey, preparedness people, it's Cynthia at The Vigs Prep. Welcome or welcome back. Today we're gonna do the wrap up of the live video from October 1st, 2022. Last night we just kept it loose. I just answered some questions from subscribers and I didn't really have a topic prepared because we just came through Hurricane Ian, and while my area didn't get much damage, we spent pretty much the whole week working and getting ready for it. And then Wednesday and Thursday, when the storm went over, we just basically held tight and made sure that we were totally ready no matter what. Thursday afternoon, we went out and cleared some of the roads because out here in the forest, a lot of times we clear our own roads. We don't wait for the county to come because they pick us last. Even though we pay our taxes just like everybody else, people in town take preference over people in more rural areas, and that's fine. So we never lost power, and we did lose internet for a few hours in the morning. By I think 2:30, it was back on. So overall, not a horrible experience, but also not exactly what I would want anyone to go through. And my heart goes out to all those people affected by the hurricane down in South Florida, because people just got wiped out. People died. It was, you know, it was not great. So I did answer some questions. A lady texted in and asked, could you use maple syrup in making jam? And another YouTuber chimed in and said, yes, but you have to use low sugar pectin. There were some great questions. I don't really remember them right now, and I'm sorry I didn't write them down. I totally should have. But we just kept it loose last night, kept the chat nice and friendly and happy. I do love all of you so, so much because you're always amazing, and my mods don't really have a hard time keeping everybody in line, so I'm very thankful for that. We had some amazing channels in the chat last night. Let me get this bread ready to rise, and then we'll do wins of the week. Here is my recipe if you want to take a screenshot of it, and please forgive the fact that I have used this recipe a lot, and it is stained and whatever. So screenshot, and then there's the rest of the directions. That is the best gluten-free bread recipe I have ever found, and I found it over at Grandma B's Busy Life. So our win for the week here at the Biggs Homestead was getting through Hurricane Ian. Not even kidding, it was kind of crazy. Yarn Prepper, who is one of my mighty mods, cleaned her yarn room, combined three containers, and then put a drawer unit out to the curb. That's part of getting your house in order. Kimber C, turned an unused space into a nice walk-in pantry. And then Hoosier Prepping Nurse, Sally, great channel if you want to go check her out. My win of the week is actually getting out into the garage and getting it organized. Again, get that house in order. Megan Donahue learned how to can ghee, meat, soup, and was able to make it all shelf stable before the hurricane. She stayed safe, so thank God for that. Monique Johnson got through the hurricane, no damage, no loss of electricity, so she rearranged her pantry room. Deborah Griffith, I got a new old wood cook stove all ready to go and cooked on it for the first time. So we'll have heat and we can cook and bake. I love that so much for her. Barbara B. in Florida. Got my first sweet potato harvest done before Hurricane Ian showed up. All my hard work paid off. The garden ended up under 10 and a half inches of water, but the container plants made it okay. Sassy Gal Prepping cleaned out more space in her basement and donated a ton of clothes to hospice thrift stores, which I love hospice thrift stores. Here in Marion County, they are hands down the best. I always donate my stuff to hospice. So now she's able to use the totes to store food in, which is so, so smart. Holly Cowan learned how to make tofu this week. Wow. Plus stocked up on canned items and tomato products from Costco. Very smart because the tomato shortage is a real thing. Ooh, my bread. Kelly S. It's a small thing, but I taught my 9-year-old how to use a church key style opener to open home canned chicken. Let me tell you what, that is not a small thing. That is you teaching your child a life skill, and those are never small. No matter how insignificant you think that is, man, they, yeah, way to go, Kelly. Glenn Anderson, win of the week is a big one. None of his friends died in the hurricane here in Florida, and thank the Lord for that. Texas Jan repackaged 30 pounds of rice and got an appointment nailed down for her oncology surgery. I'm hearing some great medical updates from people who are actually getting the services that they need. So very, very thankful for that. Jan Hatchett, harvested her first ever sweet potatoes. Way to go, Jan. A Quiet and Orderly Life, another great channel if you wanna go check her out. She homeschools and she really does have this quiet and orderly channel. Love that. Finally turned my pears into pear butter and she found her recipe. Now, no more experimenting. As a canner, you know, when you find something that works for your family, do it up. And we talked about Christmas cranberry relish, which I'll be making again this year. So excited for that. That is a family favorite at the Biggs Homestead. Sits and giggles. Praying for Florida, her win this week just happened. 40 pounds of boneless, skinless chicken breasts for $2.50 a pound. And then she explained how she was canning it and splitting it up. Way to go. Holly, finally got life-saving surgery that I needed since May, and she's recovering faster than she expected. So very thankful and a shout out for that. Nancy K went to Costco today and she bought a bunch of things to keep her from going to the McDonald's drive-thru. And we talked about there's no shame in prepping game here at the Biggs Homestead. I want you and the Biggs Prep. I want you to do what works for you. So whether it's, you know, canned food from the grocery store or, you know, whatever it is, make sure that you're doing what's right for you and your family. Not everybody has a homestead with a huge garden and goats and goat milk and all the things. I don't have that. I have a garden and I have Mr. B and we have a great life, but girl, I still buy spaghetti sauce from the grocery store, so there's no shame in that. Roseanne Torres got through Hurricane Ian with minimal damage. Mama T hit a good case sale this week. More veggies, more toilet paper, and more soup. Ja Bo dehydrating peppers and helped her niece can peaches, or his niece. I don't know what that... And then L. Just L. We don't need anything more, just L. Got the last of her zucchini shredded and in the freezer. Could be a him, not sure. Amanda Shockley have peach pits and peels in the freezer to make peach syrup this weekend. I'm coming over. That's what I said. I'm coming over. Peach syrup is one of my favorites. Lori's thrifty kitchen pantry. So Lori made it through the storm. However, she's going to need some help. So if you want to head over to her channel and just run a playlist, let the commercials play because she's going to need it. Uncle Al, mutant dwarf okra, is producing pods in the Banks homestead. Got several months' supply of medicine and medicinal supplies put away. Getting that house in order. It's so empowering when everyone shares those wins of the week. And they're my favorite part of being a YouTuber. So look for my community post on both Instagram and YouTube and share your win of the week with me and everyone else, because I feel like that brings our community together and inspires people to really get going with prepping. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you got something out of the video. I'm always live Saturday night from 8 to 9 Eastern Standard Time, talking about, usually I have a topic for the first half hour, and then the second half hour, we dig into those wins of the week. I would love to see you there, even if you can just pop in real quick and say hi. Thank you again, and remember everybody, I'd rather be a year early than a day late.